लेक्चर नंबर 7 रिलेट्स टू द प्रोविजंस ऑफ कंपनीज एक्ट 2017 रिलेटिंग टू द ऑडिट ऑफ ए कंपनीज अकाउंट्स. द सेक्शन 246 इज अबाउट अपॉइंटमेंट, रिमूवल एंड फी ऑफ ऑडिटर्स. सेक्शन 246 सब सेक्शन 1 says that a first auditor or auditors of a company shall be appointed by the board within 90 days of the date of the incorporation of the company, and the auditor or auditors so appointed shall be retired on the conclusion of the first annual general meeting. What do we mean by the incorporation? Means when the company is registered with the Securities and Exchange Commission and it came into existence, within 90 days of its existence, the auditor shall be appointed by the board, means the board of directors. Second, subsection 2, subject to the provision of the subsection 3, that will come after this. The subsequent auditors, after the first auditors, the subsequent auditors or auditors shall be appointed by the company, means the shareholders, in the annual general meeting on the recommendation of the board, after obtaining consent of the proposed auditors. Notice shall be given to the members with the notice of the general meeting. The auditor or auditors so appointed shall retire on the conclusion of the next annual general meeting. This subsection says that after the first auditors, the next auditors will be appointed by the shareholders in the annual general meeting. For this purpose, a notice shall be given to the members with the notice of the annual general meeting, and the consent of the proposed auditors shall be taken beforehand, and if they are appointed, will retire on the next annual general meeting. Now the subsection 3. In this subsection, the law states that a member or members having not less than 10% shareholding of the company shall also be entitled to propose any auditor or auditors for appointment whose consent has been taken by him, and a notice in this regard has been given to the company not less than 7 days before the date of annual general meeting. The company shall forthwith send a copy of such notice to the retiring auditor and shall also be posted on its website. The very meaning of this subsection is that any member or members who have 10% or more shareholdings of the company, they can also appoint any auditor. But they must take the consent of proposed auditors that they will work as the auditor of the company. And in notice in this regard shall be given to the shareholders before 7 days of the date of the annual general meeting. And the company, when the company will get the notice from these members, they will send this notice to the retiring auditor and also paste that notice on their website. Subsection 4 says that where an auditor other than the retiring auditor is proposed to be appointed, the retiring auditor has shall have a right to make representation in writing to the company, means the to the shareholders, at least 2 days before the date of general meeting. Such representation shall be read out at the meeting before taking up the agenda for appointment of the auditors, provided that where such representation is made, it shall be mandatory for the auditor or a person authorized by him in writing to attend the general meeting in person. Subsection 5 of section 246 says the auditor or auditors appointed by board or members in a general meeting can be removed by a special resolution. There are two types of resolutions. One is simple resolution, second is special resolution. The simple resolution is passed by the simple majority, whereas the special resolution is passed 3/4 majority, means 75% of the votes of the meeting are required to pass the special resolution. Or you may say, to remove the auditor, you require 75% vote of that meeting. The subsection 6 says, any casual vacancy of an auditor shall be filled by the board within 30 days from the date thereof. Any auditors appointed to fill in any casual vacancy shall hold office till the conclusion of the next annual general meeting. What is the casual vacancy? Generally, auditors are appointed on a general meeting and they hold their office up to the next general meeting. There is no time when the auditor is not available in the company. But there are chances if the auditors are removed, as the section subsection 5 says, or the auditor resign or auditor dies, such vacancies are called the casual vacancies. If they appear, those should be filled by the board within 30 days of the date of the creation of the vacancy. Now the subsection 7, it says, if the company fails to appoint first auditors within 90 days of its incorporation, secondly, the auditors in an annual general meeting, an auditor in the office to fill the casual vacancy, or the auditors are unwilling to act as auditors of the company. These four cases where the auditors are appointed and they are not appointed in any circumstances, the commission of its own motion or on an application made by the company or any of its members direct to make good the default within such period as may be specified in the order. If the company fails to report compliance within the period so specified, the commission shall appoint auditors of the company who shall hold office till the conclusion of the next annual general meeting. Subsection 8 says that the remuneration of auditor of a company shall be fixed by the company, means the shareholders, in the general meeting. And if the board or commission has appointed the auditor, they will fix the remuneration of the auditor as the case may be. Subsection 9 says that every company within 14 days from the date of any appointment of auditor shall send to the registrar an intimation thereof together with the consent in writing of the auditor concerned. The company will appoint the auditor, he will get the consent from the auditor that he will work for the company. Along with this consent and the appointment letter of the auditor, the company will intimate the registrar of Securities and Exchange Commission and send these copies to him.